Our top story this morning, another incident involving an Australian soldier in Afghanistan. A news conference is about to get underway in Canberra. Of course, we'll cross there live. But first, let's speak to our National Affairs editor, Paul Bongiorno, in Canberra. Paul, it is what they call the fighting season in Afghanistan this morning, but these incidents seem to be coming at shorter and shorter intervals now.
Yes, good morning, Ron. There's no doubt about this. We've now had our fourth casualty in a fortnight. The fighting season barely begun, as you say. And in Australian terms, we're heading for our bloodiest year yet in Afghanistan. Our death toll now stands at 27. I suppose to get some perspective on this, on the price that is being paid in blood for the Afghanistan commitment, the United Kingdom has lost 371 soldiers. The United States in the decade, of course they weren't continuously in Afghanistan for the whole 10 years, has lost 1,610 soldiers. So this is called a conflict.
Paul,
it's a real war.
Paul, excuse me, I need to cut in there. Air Force, rather Chief of Defence, Angus Houston, about to speak now live in Canberra.
Good morning. It is my very solemn duty this morning to report the death of another Australian soldier in Afghanistan. Yesterday evening, during a Special Operations Task Group and Afghan National Police partnered patrol, an Australian combat engineer was shot during a small arms engagement with insurgents in northern Helmand. Unfortunately, despite the rapid application of first aid and his evacuation by helicopter to the Taran Kot Roll 2 medical facility, the soldier succumbed to his wounds. As this operation has now concluded, I'm able to share with you that it involved two phases. The initial phase saw the patrol deploy to an area in northern Helmand known to be an insurgent distribution and supply cell. This was confirmed when a large munitions cache, the largest discovered by Australian forces this year, was found. It contained anti-personnel mines, rocket-propelled grenade launchers and ammunition, assault rifles, communications equipment, and components for the manufacture of improvised explosive devices. At the time of the discovery, the partnered patrol came under small arms fire from two locations. The commander on the ground made the decision to destroy the cache with explosives. The patrol then moved on to the second phase of the operation in another area of interest at a separate location. Shortly after arrival at the second location, the partnered patrol again came under heavy small arms fire from multiple directions. During this second engagement, the Special Operations Task Group soldier was shot by insurgents while he was in an overwatch position. His mates quickly moved to him under heavy fire, commenced first aid, and called for an aeromedical evacuation. Very sadly, despite these efforts, this young man could not be saved. The soldier's family were notified of their loss overnight. They are receiving assistance from Defence, and though we can't alleviate their pain, we will continue to do all we can to support them as they grieve. I offer this very close family my condolences on behalf of all the men and women of the Australian Defence Force. At the request of the family, I'm not releasing the soldier's name this morning. However, I can tell you that he was 23 years old and was on his second tour of Afghanistan, having previously deployed with Reconstruction Task Force 3 in 2007. I understand the soldier was a superb young man whose easygoing nature made him very popular within his unit. He was extremely fit, as you would expect of a qualified combat fitness leader. He was also a great team member, dedicated and professional, whose range of skills and qualifications were more than you would rightly expect of someone so young. Though nothing will ease their sense of loss, I want this soldier's family to know that their loved one, his SOTG mates, and their Afghan National Police partners were undertaking vital work in Afghanistan yesterday. The discovery and destruction of this massive cache of weapons, ammunition, and improvised explosive device components will undoubtedly prevent other casualties and will impede the insurgency in northern Helmand and in Uruzgan. This brave young soldier is the fourth we have lost in just over 2 weeks, undoubtedly making this a very difficult time for us all, but most importantly, the families of all the soldiers we have lost in Afghanistan. However, I know our soldiers on the ground are incredibly resilient and determined. They believe they are making a substantial difference. They believe they are winning. While this will shake them, I am confident that they will continue making a substantial and enduring contribution to Afghanistan. I will now take your questions.
Defence Chief Angus Houston there reporting the death of another Australian soldier in Afghanistan. Let's go back to our National Affairs Editor Paul Bongiorno in Canberra. Paul, how soon can we expect the Prime Minister to offer her condolences and to speak on this matter?
Well, Ron, in a sense, the government's been caught out today. The Prime Minister, as we speak, is in the air on her way to Alice Springs, and the Defence Minister is in Brussels. One would expect that the Prime Minister will have something to say when she lands in Alice Springs. And of course, we would expect the Defence Minister to put out a statement shortly.
Paul, we always ask this question after these incidents, but does this, another death, as Angus Houston just said, it's now four deaths in 2 weeks. At what stage do we start to see overwhelming political pressure to bring our troops home from Afghanistan with these continuing list of deaths?
Well, there's no doubt that the mounting death toll will undermine the loss of confidence that we need to still be there, that the public seems to have. There were opinion polls run over the weekend that showed that a majority of Australians now believe that the job is done in Afghanistan and nothing more can be gained there. And I think this was the importance of the statement that the Defence Force Chief made just before we left him, that our soldiers are resilient and they believe they're making a difference, and the patrol, the mission they were on overnight did blow up a cache of ammunition and of arms that would weaken the insurgency. So this is the military rationale for us being there. Questions are being asked, is the time drawing near that we look for a political solution, that somehow we bring the Taliban into the tent? We do know that there's a 2014 sort of deadline that the Americans, the Afghans and ourselves are talking about. But, of course, for that to have credibility, there have to be real benchmarks.
All right, Paul, thank you. Our National Affairs Editor, Paul Bongiorno, live from Canberra.